If you watched my last video, then you'll know that I'm currently covering a story surrounding Patrice Désilets, who was previously the creator of Assassin's Creed and the director of that series up until Brotherhood, I believe. And now he started his own indie studio called Panache Digital, and he had some things to say about the fact that his latest game, Ancestors: The Humankind Odyssey, didn't get as high a Metascore as his previous endeavors. He says right here how he's used to having bigger numbers than what he got for Ancestors, and how this is an elephant in the room. He claimed that there was this expectation of him making a game as epic as Assassin's Creed, despite his studio being 35 people. Which I don't really think is true, not for the most part, at least. I think most people understood that this is an indie studio and that they have limited resources and that this game, Ancestors, would be on a smaller scale. And then, perhaps most contentious of all is when he said, "We know for a fact that some reviewers actually didn't play the game." He specifically cited how certain outlets made up elements in the game. So, he talks right here about how you cannot ride horses and there is no fire in Ancestors, and yet one reviewer said, "Oh, it wasn't that great when you ride a horse." So the thing that I want to point out in this video, which I couldn't last time because I didn't actually know which reviews he was referring to, are the reviews that in fact did mention things like fire and riding horse, despite those elements not being in the game. So first up, we have this review discussion by GameSpot, which you can see right here has an update that was published on October 16th, 2019. And then if you look at how this page looked like when this video was first published on August 31st, 2019, it looked something like this without the update, but then it would seem as though on October 16th, they updated this video description to more accurately represent the information relayed there. So this update reads, quote, "This episode of GameSpot After Dark contains a few incorrect statements regarding Ancestors: The Humankind Odyssey, namely players having the ability to ride horses and create fires, and that creatures other than apes evolve over time. Our reviewer came to these conclusions based on aspects of the game that suggest such possibilities, but after further clarification from Private Division, we now understand these elements are not part of the game. GameSpot regrets the error. For a more detailed look at Ancestors: The Humankind Odyssey, be sure to check out our full review for a complete breakdown of its sprawling, open-ended campaign." So here is GameSpot's review of the game. As you can see, they gave it a pretty low score, a 4, and according to this excerpt, the reviewer played about 35 hours in Ancestors, and it should be noted that in this review, there is no mention of horses or fires. It's just in the post-review discussion where that was brought up. So it seemed as though GameSpot might be the outlet that Patrice Désilets might have been referring to. And then there is this news outlet, mspoweruser.com, whose review cited certain elements that didn't exist in the game as well, and as a result, they had to publish this update that reads, quote, "Our review of Ancestors provided a small aside statement that the act of building fires was a mundane activity. Since the publishing of this article, it has come to light that the act of crafting a fire is not something the player can do. The statement has since been retracted. We did not mean to publish an inaccuracy regarding this title. All of our reviews are written by a passionate team of gamers and tech enthusiasts. While a review with a factual inconsistency is never something we wish to publish, it is something that happened. We would like to formally apologize to the team behind Ancestors and the game's creator, Patrice Désilets. While playing the title for review, our reviewer accidentally wrote building fires was a mundane activity. He meant building resting spots. It's a small slip-up, but one we would like to humbly apologize for. We would never mean to misrepresent the title, not only for the respect of our readers, but for the respect of the hardworking teams that create such intricate and amazing titles. Even with this slight factual inconsistency, we don't feel that this affects our score. We stand by our original score of Ancestors, but we are very sorry if you feel the title has been misrepresented." It's weird that both GameSpot and MS Power User managed to get the same thing wrong about fires being in the game. But yeah, it would seem as though GameSpot and MS Power User were the two outlets that Patrice was referring to when he talked about how we know for a fact that some reviewers didn't actually play the game. Now, according to GameSpot, this reviewer did play 35 hours of the game, and then he slipped up when he mentioned things like riding horses and fire. As for this MS Power User article, it doesn't say how long they played this game for, but this is definitely the kind of slip-up that will make people question the legitimacy of your review. Now, the accusation that Patrice is throwing out there is that they clearly didn't play the game. Given the information in the review, based on the information highlighted here, which matches what others have discussed in terms of the game's gameplay elements and its various features, I don't get the sense that this individual didn't play the game, but definitely having a slip-up like this certainly does put a damper on people's ability to trust this specific review. But I do think Patrice is engaging in a way where it poisons the entire well. Yes, there is bad apples out there in terms of reviews, but if you look at the Metascore and the user score, and if you read through most of these reviews, you will see that they are all in agreement about very specific things and very specific issues about the game. A lot of the criticisms are damn near universal about this game, and that's what Patrice is trying to sort of sideline by saying that it had to do with people's expectations and by saying that some reviewers didn't play the game. He's sort of generalizing and saying that the entire review process for the game was unfair by highlighting some of these reviewers who did get certain statements wrong. And right here, he highlights Ancestors and makes it out to be a very special case, stating that since Ancestors is so different, some of them went, ugh, I don't have time for this, as if to say my game is so special that people just didn't give it a fair chance. It's so unique and out there that clearly there's some foul play involved. That's kind of the narrative he's putting out there, and there's just no backing for that because most reviewers clearly play the game. Even if you take out the bad apples, the Metascore really wouldn't change all that much. And hell, I mean, one of the bad apples actually gave it a decent score. It gave it a 7, which is pretty good. And then he claims right here that he believes some didn't understand it before they gave up trying, stating that the game needs like an hour or two before you kind of get it. But a lot of most of these reviews, you can read them and you can clearly get the sense that they definitely played more than 2 hours. And most of these reviews did finish the game from beginning to end and stated the exact same things, talked about the same gameplay elements, and talked about the same problems. And then right down here, he even admits that the game wasn't really as finished as it could have been, talking about all of these tutorial elements that they were planning to add to the game that they just couldn't implement in time before the game launched. So I have no issue with Patrice highlighting the fact that certain reviews clearly got facts wrong and calling them out on it. I think that's totally fair. But what he's implying here, again, within the context of this conversation surrounding the Metascore of his game, is that the reviewers not playing his game, some of them not playing his game, had a drastic influence in the outcome of Ancestors Metascore. And then he says right here how sometimes game reviewers will have 15 games in 1 week to review, and that may result in reviewers not giving each game its full attention. And while I'm not going to claim that there isn't some of that, it's important to highlight that a lot of these major news outlets have a team of people and they get different games assigned to different people so that each individual can have all the time they need with one particular game. And that's how a lot of these reviews were carried out, and 99% of them do not say anything about Riding Horses or Fire or put out erroneous statements. They all say that this is a game with potential, that has some interesting ideas, that unfortunately falls short on the execution side of things. But there are also some reviews saying that, hey, this game's pretty interesting, pretty good. A lot of people were also compelled by it, so it's got mixed reviews for all intents and purposes. And that's the nature of his game, and I believe that Patrice has to just accept that and try to look at the criticism that's valid, because there's plenty of valid criticism out there, and then use that to make a better game next time, rather than try to create this narrative that his game didn't score as well because the reviewers somehow did a poor job. When he says some reviewers didn't play the game, it's easy to infer that he might be saying that there's a good amount of them that didn't play his game and didn't do his game justice and didn't review it fairly. He is factually correct in saying that there were some reviews that talked about Fires and Riding Horses when that's not even a thing in the game, and that's absolutely something he should point out. But he can't make that such a big emphasis and such a big fault for Ancestors falling short in terms of reviews. The fact of the matter is his game's just flawed, And that's fine. You know, he can pick himself back up and make another game that's even better, that learns from mistakes. But I just hope that he's actually willing to keep an open mind and learn from mistakes rather than completely try to scapegoat blame to expectations from people or a couple bad apples in the reviewers, on Metacritic, so on and so forth. So that's just my take. Let me know in the comments below what your take is on this situation in the comments below. With that, I would like to end this news update and discussion video. Thank you for tuning in. To be further updated on all things gaming news, reviews, and discussions, stay tuned right here on Yong Yeah. I'll see you guys next time. Yong out.